Thank you right now for all that you are doing at this present moment.
But you can give him strength in his natural body. Give him wisdom and knowledge how to guide this way, Father. Not right here, God. Right here, God. Located here, God. Guide us, God. Guide him, Lord. Help him, God. Bless his body by his side, God. In the name of Jesus. Give strength to the body, God. Give wisdom, God. How to nurture, God. In the name of Jesus.
People are just born today, laying there.
Exhale and inhale and say, hallelujah.
Oh. things, and we think we know, but he's so much more. He's full of wonder.
Yes,
that's a wonderful man. Not just wonder, but wonder. Hey, that was China. He's full of wonder. And we bless him today. We bless him not just for what he's done, but who he is. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Ah, the devil didn't like that one. I didn't like of his devices. About COVID, you know, anybody ever know COVID? You just put the phlegm in my throat, but I'm saying he's wonderful. Yeah. But just because you did that, he's wonderful. Yeah. I'll leave that shit with me. He's good.
Let us get.
no slingshot.
I know.
Tell me. Tell me.
Ooh.
Yes.
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 Oh.
Church,
yes.
The Apostolic,
yes.
A mighty
Online, we give through Zelle, we give through Givelify, and we now have Cash App that Lady P can give you. I believe it's $RTALLA. Amen. RTALLA. Amen. That's our Cash App. She was tiny. Okay. Amen. Amen. We're learning this sign language here. Amen. If someone wants to still give in the sanctuary, our basket is here. You may freely bring it. Amen. We thank God for whatever you give.
Yes.
It is blessed because this is good ground.
All right.
And God has blessed it. Amen. And we are a blessing to be here to receive it and make sure it's put to the glory of God.
Yes.
So we ask God to bless you for giving and bless it to return to you for fourfold, amen, threefold, a hundredfold, amen, amen. He's able to do that. He's done it so many times before, amen. And I won't delay. Are there any announcements before I turn it over to the hand of the pastor? Amen. At this time, we want to bring to you the pastor of the Revelation Church, Apostolic Faith, Glenn Wayne Perkins. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen. We're so happy to see you, Sister Ruby. So happy to see you. Saw your signs too the other day. Amen. Your granddaughter. Amen. Yes. Amen. God is good. Right now, we're going to have our pastor come. Amen. You'd like to have some words? Ruby, would you like to have some words? We're glad you're back in town.
Angel came to me in my dream and told me to go tell God on his way back. So I'm going to get up and I'm going to reconfirm my membership in the church.
Thank God for Bishop Paul and Lady Ford one more time. God bless them.
we got a, we're looking forward to a beautiful service. Lord God, we thank God again for what God has done, what He continued on doing. Last night, we just had a beautiful time. Apostle Person preached his heart out. Glory to God. Oh, my God. Preached. But we thank God for what God is doing, though. But again, this time, we get ready to actually be, everyone will stand. We're going to present the song and introduce the elders. This great man of God. Bishop Paul Ford at this time. Say, preach your word. Bishop Ford.
To pray my request. what God told me. Going to come against tradition. Tradition. Most people, that is, churches, and you don't like what you can say, but it's biblical. As long as God is honoring it, I don't care. Amen. Amen. I got God's approval, and we're going to start. Amen. It ain't the title that gave me the approval. It's the word of God that gave me the approval. It's what God gave me that sealed it, that made it so. So we want to go forward. Amen. And we thank God for this blessing. Amen. Pastor Perkins and Lady Perkins, that will become something in a few. Amen. But to God be the glory for what he is doing and what he's going to do, and to my lovely companion. Amen. We thank God for Jesus. If you would look for a quick second, go with me to the book of 2 John. 1 John, 2 John. Let me see. 2 John, the second epistle of John. Look at the scripture according to what he says. Second epistle, John, verses 1-5. And the elders to the elect lady and her children, whom I loved in the truth. And not only I, but also all they that have known the truth, for the truth's sake, which dwelleth in us, and all be with us forever. Grace be with you, mercy and peace from God the Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Father, in truth and love. I rejoice greatly that I have found of thy children walking in truth, as we have received the commandment from the Father. And now I beseech you, lady, not as I write a new commandment unto thee, but that which we have from the beginning, that we love one another. May the Lord have a blessing to the reading, hearing, and understanding of his word. We are accustomed as a church, religion world, of calling the pastor's wife first lady. It's not biblical. It's not in the word of God. Okay. You will find the word elect 17 times in the Bible. The word elect means chosen. Predestinated, preserved. God have mercy.
Thank you, Lord.
It's 4 times in the Old Testament, 13 times in the New. 13 times in the New. But for here, he said to the elect lady. So where are we getting first lady from? We are talking about not bringing the world into the church, but we are taking what the world says and applying it to the church. The world
word first lady comes from what they call the first lady of the White House.
Yes. Amen.
This is God's house.
Yes.
So what God said in his house is order. He said he called her elect. Watch this. It was something that I caught when he was giving it to me. He said, it's manly. Uh-oh. And if you really look at it, man-made people do man-made things.
Yes.
I don't care how good you shout. I don't care how good you heal my mama. Oh, blah, 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 blah. Matches color, the same color as the pastor. That ain't nothing. But God assigns a certain anointing on the lady that's assigned to the man of God.
Okay, okay, okay.
You ain't got to like it. It ain't your job to like it. She's there to purify you. Maybe they didn't like that term.
Go ahead, go ahead.
All right.
Watch this. God assigned the man of God to be the shepherd over the people of God, but he assigned that woman to be the helpmate to him. So in order for him to give what he needs, he gotta have somebody that's there for him. Everybody ain't anointed to be with God's man.
True, true, true. True.
You gotta like me today. No, God.
It's all right.
Pray God. Better love me.
Yes.
You ain't gotta like me. Better love me. No, you don't love me, you in trouble.
Better yet.
Look, she got the keys. She got the keys.
What I've learned is that I'm not seeking for you to love me.
That's right.
Pastor, I'm not seeking for nobody to love me. Especially if I'm walking in what God told me to walk in.
That's it.
Woo, tell it.
That's it.
You ain't going to love me if I'm walking in what, because what I'm walking in is going against your flesh. And because it goes against your flesh, you are mad at God. You ain't mad at me. So why am I taking it personally?
Did y'all hear what Apostle said to my wife last night?
Mm-hmm.
He said, you dare to strengthen. Watch this.
He ain't going to always agree with the strength. You ain't going to always agree with it, Pastor. Don't even think you is. Don't even.
Mm-hmm.
I think you should. Look, honey. Let's do it this way. I see. Oh, but I see it. I see what you're saying, but I see it. And then when it. Oh, well, let's pick up what you said there. No. She there.
We ain't got this thing. We ain't got this thing by ourselves.
But we are pulling things in from the world and expecting God to bless us. Y'all didn't see him run. You might have saw a little bit. Yeah. They might have saw a little bit. Facebook might have saw a little bit. But you don't know what the running was for.
All right. That's it.
Goliath got it down.
Say it.
And he's going to die. He will die.
Yes.
And sometimes, Watch this. Y'all didn't hear what she was saying. I was listening. I was trying to behave and trying to listen at the same time. She said, you got to. Sometimes the whining is slow and in the beginning, but when the anointing comes,
yes,
I'm ready.
Yes,
ready, but I'm not going to release it until you tell me to.
Yes.
I'm still whining up.
Glory, go.
What did he say in Sunday school? He said, I want to fight.
Glory to God.
I can go ahead and do it, but it's not in season and my time. He said, he told me to. Paul said, watch what he said. Paul said, wait on your ministry. Did he say jump out there and go? He said, wait on it. What are you saying? You should be hooping and hollering, no? We need to teach this. Because there's too many people. You're looking for God to bless you, but you're going out of the word of God. You're tearing away from what God is saying, and then you want him to bless you, but he can't bless you if you don't use his word. Watch this. It was so, he said, if man made title born out of tradition a man. So I turned around and I said, Lord, I want to hoop a little while I'm there. He said, I didn't tell you to hoop, I want you to teach.
Right.
We are accustomed of following what we want to do and what we think is right and try to bring God in. And God is saying, I'm not in that. And if he's not in it, how can he anoint it?
That's it. True.
He can't anoint something that he's not in. So he turned around and he said to the elect lady, who are found, not only you, but your children, walking in, watch it. My baby ain't in the church. God didn't tell you that your baby got to be in the building. He said they got to be walking in the truth. What did you teach them? What did you live? What did you stand on? They might not do everything you want them to do, but they know the truth.
Yeah.
Said, found walking in the truth. Then he said, I rejoice greatly that I found thy children walking in the truth. And as we have received a great commandment from the Father, what did you hand me? What did you give them? We got too many people walking around in tradition and don't know God. You shout all day long, you buck all day long, you and don't know God. Ain't never had a personal experience. I used to tell why it used to be right there. I think it was Sister Swager right here. And somebody right here took the rolling one right here. This is the soprano section, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a soprano. This was alto, and this was the tenor.
Yeah, yeah.
But this is soprano. Soprano always had this wall.
Yeah.
Sister Swager always had this wall.
Yeah.
you. And I was bad. Revelation, I was bad. But if you can save me, you can save anybody.
Yeah, great.
Wait here. Brother Troy teaching. Turn around, tell my wife, I said, boy, he's gonna make me pull this car over and shout on the freeway. He's holding himself in. I said, I'm in the car yelling like he can hear me. Let it go. Why? Because when you let God do what he needs to do, when I get here, it ain't hard for me to do what God tells me to do.
That's it. That's it.
Don't quench the spirit. Let him do what he got to do. Everybody's, you had a 5-hour service. Well, if you stayed in and listened for 5 hours, you ought to got something out of it. You walked away from that service, you didn't get something. Something wrong with you. That man could preach about it. He said, watch this. And now I perceive you, lady, not as though I write a new commandment unto thee, but that which we had from the beginning. What was given from the beginning? That lady right there had a vision from the beginning. We ain't detoured from what she God gave her. We build it on what God gave her.
That's it. That's it.
He give us new revelation, new insight, so that we can build on. We ain't taking away from what we building. You want religious people to come in? I don't want no religious people in Revelation. I ain't the pastor, I'm bishop. I'm saying I don't want no religious people in Revelation. You religious, stand where you are. I need somebody that got a mind to do what God says. He said, not that we gave you a new command. Same one that we did from the beginning. That thing has never failed.
That's it.
60 years. Mm-hmm. It's still standing.
Yeah. Yeah.
You ain't got to be happy about it. I'm excited. Because the foundation of God stands assured.
Hallelujah. Glory.
They taught what they understood that they knew at the time.
That's it. Yes. Yes.
It's not that they was teaching wrong. It was what God gave them at that time. But what are you bringing it to now? Ooh. What revelation is he giving you now?
Now.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I can't be Bishop Carter. I might can play the tambourine like him, but I can't beat him. But I promise you, his anointing still stands on me. What they did was what they knew.
Yes.
And God honored it because that's what they knew. But he said, I'm giving you the same commandment that I gave you from the beginning. Go back to what he said to you.
Woo.
In the beginning.
Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Hallelujah.
Do you remember Woo. What he spoke to you in the beginning?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I don't know if y'all remember, but Pastor, and let it be, I preached the message, here, answer the call.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
You was here. Pastor was here. I told you. God said, there's some people that's at your job that watching you. Dr. God, well,
I ain't got bad memory. But some things I do forget. But when God speaks, I ain't dying. He bring all things to your remembrance.
All right.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
It's been so many years ago. That was before. That's why you was this minister. Boy, he ain't no pastor. You ain't God. That's why you can't come here. I'm gonna tell the truth. That's why you can't come here, because you gonna disrespect God. And God will cut you off right here.
Yes, he will.
Y'all think I'm lying?
Nope.
I never seen Bishop. I don't know the bishop's name, but the man preached at a bishop college appreciation. Preach. And yeah. Got up to do the dismissal.
Elder Lashley.
And fell dead.
Elder Lashley.
Paramedics try to get him back. Well, but when God said you done, the scary daylights out.
So I ain't never want to preach behind that
pole. You fall dead behind him. I don't want to preach behind this pole. Look what I'm doing now. Tradition is not God. And God is not tradition. So why are we trying to be tradition, trying to please people, when God promised that he'll send the people if we get away from tradition? He can't send them if you want to program them to do what you want them to do, and it's not what God tells you to do. You want people. Yes, you go. You won't have people. But watch what he said. He said, everybody I send, I'm going to require on your end. You want people to come just to come so you can have numbers? They don't live sad, they don't act sad. You put them in position, you all this. Oh, hey. God gonna get you. Elect lady has authority. Listen to me. Tell you what God told me. Has authority. You remember what he said to Ezekiel? Speak to them.
Yes.
Speak to the wind. Ezekiel said, Lord, only you know if they can live. Only you know, God, whether they live or whether they die. He said, now I'm going to tell you how to get them to live.
Speak. I am a
son. Whatever I tell you to speak, I'm going to bring it to pass.
Hallelujah.
He said, everything was in a valley of dry bones. And the Bible said, this bone went to, listen, he didn't say they was all together, they was all spread out.
Yes.
Now, how did this bone know where to go with that bone? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Because God spoke, yes. And the bones know what to do.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
So when he gave elect lady, he gave them a certain authority that they can speak. They're not taking over. But they're speaking what God has.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
What are they speaking? What he gave them from the beginning.
Yes.
Pastor Person told me something, blew my mind. Said that Pastor P, let it be how we talk. Said this man blew my mind. He said, what you need, what the word that you got at the age of 16 is the same word you need at 109. Then he used different A's in between. Said this man, only God can give a revelation like this. He said, but it's the same word. Watch this.
Same word.
Watch this. What word did you hear, God, for you to believe, God, that he is, that he is, that to receive what he promised you to have? That word is still what you need to make it to rapture.
Yes.
He didn't tell you to grab another popcorn word. He told you, my word is truth. And the word that you grab, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. The word that you grab to believe, God.
Jesus. Glory.
It's the same word you need now. Build. Don't just get it and just sit. Build. Live it. Help us not to be hearers only, but doers of your word.
Yes.
I don't want to just hear what you're saying to me. I don't care about the title. I want you to be pleased. What are you pleased with? I performed the word of God according to what you told me to do.
Glory. Jesus.
What are you saying?
Turn around. Read another scripture. Troy, he said, Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. Who are you? Why the reason he said, who are you? Because you came in your own authority. You came in your title. You came in thinking that you were something. I know Paul. I know Jesus. But I don't know you. I see your title, but your title don't mean nothing to me. You whooped the mess out of me. But when it came in the name of the Lord, when I came,
let me behave because I feel like preaching like Swanson. When I came in the name of the Lord, there's a difference. When I come in the name of the Lord, I'm coming in authority. Before the foundation of the world, God has selected. Listen to me. God selected you. You didn't select this position. God selected you.
Jesus.
Y'all didn't hear what I said.
Yes, I did.
Let me break it down a different way. You didn't just marry Lady P.
Woo-hoo.
Because you love Lady P. You married Lady P because God authorized it.
Hallelujah.
Because down the line, he knew that he was going to fill you.
nasty, but you stay faithful. You cry sometimes, but you remain faithful. God, I need you. God, I can't do it without you. God, if you call me, God, if you anoint me, I do what you tell me to do. So you marry Lady P, and the devil thought that you're going to be outside and just be glad. Be Perkins. Just, they know me because I'm a football player. I got status. When I hit them, they knew they got hit. But what you didn't know is that when you hit them, they didn't go down because of the hit. They went down because of the anointing that was coming up.
Glory, glory, glory.
Let me leave y'all alone.
Go ahead, go ahead.
I don't want to have church.
Go ahead. No.
It was already predestined. It was already set up. This thing was already done. Before the foundation of the world, God already knew what he was going to do. There's a difference in them that are called and them that are chosen. The call cannot do the job of the chosen, but the chosen can do the job of the call.
Right. Hallelujah.
Y'all didn't hear what I said to you. You're trying to do something that God did not authorize you to do because you're not called to it. You're just called, but with your call, that means you gotta wait. Because you're not prepared, you're not seasoned, you're not ready for it. But them that are chosen, them that are chosen, they're not running from the call, they're running from the chosen. He swept this temple clean.
So he clapped, he swept it clean. And watch this. And the enemy that was in here went and grabbed 7 verses in himself to try to come back in. Well, the reason that he can't come back in here is because the anointing was already in here.
Yes. Yeah, 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 yeah.
And he sealed it.
Say that.
Go ahead, go ahead.
All right.
So when he called you a elect lady, he sealed it. This is God's doing. He sealed it. And watch this. And after he sealed it, he stamped his approval.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He just didn't seal it. But he stamped his approval.
Yes.
To show the enemy, this is me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you show up at Perkins' house if you want to. But this is me. Can I say this? Let me say this. You wonder why sometimes you fight what you fight is because who you connected to.
Hallelujah.
Y'all think I'm crazy? Let me show you something. Apostle Person last night told you to anoint me and do this, right? Everybody thought that it should have been an apostle doing it. But what apostle was saying was that he was sealing the ministry between me and Pastor Perkins together. He was sealing.
Yes, he was.
It was sealed.
Yeah.
If he would have did it, I could not connect to him the way God told me to connect with him.
Hallelujah.
So he turned around and said, anoint him, preacher. Let the shepherd of the house do it. Anoint him. I'm going to speak what God told me to speak, but I need you to anoint him, because what God is about to do with you and him, I'm just going to be a part of it.
Hallelujah.
This church ain't going down.
No, it's not.
Let me get the microphone so I can say it. So Facebook can hear me. You want to talk about this being a family church? The reason that you talk like that is because you're not a part of the family. This ain't an Elvers church.
No. Thank you, Jesus.
This ain't a Transcendent church.
No.
So you outside of the family and you're mad because you want to come in and wreak havoc in the house of God, and the anointing ain't going to let you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I can't be a part of them. That's a family church. Well, I thought we was brothers and sisters. I thought you was a part of the family. Yes, I did. But you know, when you start doing things, I heard Lady B tell us, she said, I told them I ain't getting no whooping because of you. You gonna do what I say, I'm gonna whoop you. Cause I'm not gonna get no whooping cause you ain't doing what mama told me that you better do before she get home. But mama ain't gonna, she might get you, but she gonna give me more cause I'm the oldest. The responsibility was given to me.
Yeah, keep going.
The reason that you're outside of the family is because you're doing what you want to do and not what God said do. So he turned around, the Bible said, he said, have no fellowship with them until they come to themselves. I'm teaching apostolic now. Have no fellowship. I cut my family off. Yes, I did. And I hope they watch. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for loving. But if you ain't gonna do what God told you to do, you ain't my brother, you ain't my sister. Them that do the will of my Father is my brother and sister. Told my wife flying out here, I said, I got a brother. I hope he watches. I got a brother. One of my brothers left. Only got one brother. Said, but he ain't my brother. Now think what you want.
Preach, preach.
You walk away from God, you ain't my brother. You tradition, you ain't my brother. Sat on the plane and told my wife, I said, I'm going to go see my real brother. She looked at me. I said, Troy is my real brother. She said, I said, we used to come down here and rehearse songs and everything. And I'd get behind him to do Deacon Flowers.
Yeah.
He'd be sitting over there on the organ laughing at me. Cut the mic off. He'd be cracking up at me. Lord have mercy. Save him, Lord. And I'm not saved. I ain't got the Holy Ghost, but save the Lord, save them. They need your anointing, save. But I ain't got no Holy Ghost. He sat there, he cracked up. Turned around, told me, he said, you're gonna get a church. The name of your church is gonna be Hallway of Holiness. If they don't do it your way, they ain't holy. They ain't saved. I don't know if he remember. I ain't got no bad memory. Turn around, I said, I got the Holy Ghost. And I said, well, I'm going to try to do a tarrying service. Because I want them to get what I got. So I called Z, I called Troy, and I got Jennifer, and I told him, meet me at Revelation. I didn't know Bishop Tyler and Philly was in the back. I'm out here with them. Come on, call them, call them, call them, call them, call them. Yes, yes. I'm thinking that I can do what the season saints do. Find myself at the altar. Bishop Tyler and Philly had to come and carry with them, and I'm at the altar. Listen, let me get this last scripture. Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. One of the preachers wrote in his statement, he said, that's the fullness to captivate me, draws your attention. Sometimes you gotta make people laugh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you do. God got a sense of humor. Yes, he do.
Yes, he does.
Somebody said, no, you don't. Yes, he do. Look at your face. He got a sense of humor. From one person, you ugly, to the next person, you're beautiful. He got a sense of humor. Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Y'all don't hear what I'm saying.
He got a sense of humor.
Oh, good.
Something he tells you to do. What, you sure you asking me to do that? You sure? Not because I ain't willing, but me? No, I know me. I cut you up real quick. You want me? You want me? Have a situation in Florida right now. My wife would let me tell them what I do. I said, no, go, leave it alone. Leave it alone. You ain't rejected me. You rejected God. I ain't mad at you. Thank you for the fellowship that we had. Appreciate the time that we spent together. Now it's time for me to keep growing. And where he's taking me, you might not be able to help me to get there. Right. So thank you for the time that we spent together. Yes. And I'm moving on.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Got nothing against you. I'm not mad at you. I'm just moving forward. So no disrespect. But God put who he want around you when he want. Listen, you can't go into a season and God don't equip you for the people that he.
That's it.
So you was in my season while I was a pastor. Now he's going to equip me with people that can hold me up as a bishop. You can't do it. I ain't mad at you. I love you in Jesus. We a fellowship if you want a fellowship. You don't want a fellowship, I ain't mad at you. I'm going to keep it pushing. You didn't ordain. We had an ordination service, but you didn't ordain. Pastor Person did the service, but he didn't ordain. God ordained.
Yes.
He just did the ceremony. Watch this. Romans chapter 8. Watch this. Verse 28. And we know all things work together for the good to them that love God and to them that are called according to his purpose, from whom he did foreknow. From whom he did foreknow. He also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among the brethren. You were being, watch this. Now I'm gonna talk to them for a second. I love y'all. I'm gonna talk to them for a second. Lady Ford was learning how to be elect lady from 2015. Lady P started in 2017. But she was already walking in it before 2017. She just was comfortable. I'm married to the pastor. Yes. Oh, I love God. and do everything that the pastor needed her to do, but didn't understand that God was fostering and walking her in footsteps of what God wanted her to be for this season and now. My wife was in training because she was never in church.
Go ahead.
Hear what I'm saying.
Go ahead.
See, you can be church and be out of church.
Yeah.
So God had to use somebody that can be connected to me that wasn't in church, that know he can trust to walk what God said in church. Don't leave.
Yeah.
from 2017, 2015, they've been in training. But when God said it's time for promotion, man can't do nothing about it. When God said you can't do nothing about it, it was predestined before the foundation of the world. Look what he says. Moreover, whom he did predestine, them he also called. And whom he called, them he justified. And them that he justified, he glorified.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mm. Jesus.
Y'all didn't hear what I said. See, let me explain this to you. The calling helps you to walk in the season of being prepared. Now that I'm being prepared, now that I'm going through the trial and the tribulation, and I haven't given up, I'm learning who God is.
Yes, yes.
So after I've been called, now he's justifying me, meaning he's preparing me, he's seasoning me. Mm-hmm. He's seasoning me. He's taking out of me what that I don't need and putting in me what I need. But in the preparing, in the seasoning, he's watched it. So sometimes he felt a hiccup.
Go ahead, preach it.
You don't know what a hiccup is. Watch this. Sometimes you felt the hit. And the hit made you. Okay, what am I not seeing? What am I not? Wait. God, what are you doing? What are you showing me?
Yes, yes.
What are you telling me?
Yes.
What? I'm awake. I'm going to sit here and take a show. Give me clarity and revelation and understanding. I want to make sure that I see it clearly so that when I step out in you and not in you. Mm. So he's seasoning. And in seasoning, watch this. You know how certain people season their meat? They marinate. That there's time that God has to marinate you.
That's it.
I'll leave that alone. Let me leave that alone. Let me.
Right.
So he called, he justified. And now, after he do the justification, now he's going to get glory. He's going to get glory. Isn't there a song that said he get glory after this?
Yes, there's glory after this.
There's some glory after this.
Jesus.
Go ahead.
Watch this. There's things that you had a conversation with God about that you don't remember. You thought that you had it, and you remember that you had it, but it wasn't the way you thought.
Yeah.
You prayed about it, you talked to him about it, but you don't remember how you talked to him about it. And certain things you talked to him about, the Holy Ghost stepped in and took over the conversation. So now that he's getting glory,
Go ahead.
Listen, watch this. Everybody can be elect. Because everybody ain't willing to sell out. This is sell out. This is sell out. Yes, it is. This is sell out. It ain't about being married to the pastor. I sold out.
If he walk away from his calling, I'm sold out to God. I'm still do what God told me to do. I'm going to love him anyway. I'm going to be that helpmate that I need to be. But brother, you better step back in position.
That's it. Glory, 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 glory.
What's her name? Tasha Carr? She sung a song and she said, hey, you need to get back in your seat.
As a person preached about to see, you need to get back to this.
Get back to what they said, yes. I got another yes. It ain't about me, it's about God.
Mm-hmm. You hear what I'm saying? And he glorified. Mm-hmm. Because watch this. He already seasons you. He already can trust you with it. Now he's going to be glorified in everything that you walk in, because you ain't going to walk in nothing but what he tells you to do. That he get the glory.
Let me say this.
Watch this. Everyone came off this. Everybody. Right. So you don't remember the conversation that you had with God. With God.
Yes.
And he's going to not only watch this, he ain't going to just remember what he's going to do. He's going to install it in you so that when you walk in it, it be what he called you to do. God, you.
So we are here today with permission, the authority that God has given us to install them as you let ladies.
Well, I don't know.
Apostle Person was singing songs yesterday. I said, Lord Jesus.
I ain't never heard that song, but it was anointed.
Yeah.
It was anointed. I was watching Troy. I said, I hope he didn't catch you. I hope he didn't catch you. Because I don't know where he's going.
I don't know where he's going, but he put his own words to a song. And it was right on time. Amen. Come on, y'all. Let it be and ready for it. Come on. Amen. Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
First Timothy chapter 5, verse 21 says, I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ and the elect angels that thou observe these things without preferring one before another, doing nothing by partiality, doing nothing by partiality. Romans chapter 8:33 said, who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died. Yea, rather, that is risen again, who is then at the right hand of God, who make intercession for us. This day forward, no one can lay anything to your charge because God. Devil show up, tell him God got it.
My soul, 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 my so
saying. I agree with 100%. Except this is not my effort.
This is Mama Emma right here. But today, God has rested on you as Mama Emma.
You lay hands on them behind me.
Mama Emma's anointing is going to touch you.
Mama, sit up.
This baby is going to be sealed for God's approval. There's another yes. There's another yes. Your license as minister, as you're going to say, like, lady, you're in that position now. But there's another yes that you want to get between you and God before next year. That when the license is given, that yes will match the license. So with your permission, we now lay in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
In the name
Fire.
Of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, we lay hands on your elect lady. Stir the gift. Stir the gift. Activate it now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, say that the blood, yours, God, whatever our hands touch, let your anointing fall in the name of Jesus Christ. Touch now. Stir now. In the name of Jesus. Let your oil that was poured be double. In the name of Jesus Christ. Double anointing. In the name. Anoint her hands. Anoint her feet. In the name of Jesus. Everything that she tread over will come under subjection. In the name of Jesus. You seal it. Do it now. Do it now. Do it now. In the name of Jesus. 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 Now, God, do it in the name of Jesus. Seal it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Double anointing, double anointing, double anointing, double anointing. In the name of Jesus. Take over now. Take over now. Anointing, take over now. Shower down. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Do it now, God.
So for people that don't know what we do, they are no more Lady. They are no more Lady Perkins. This day forward, they are elected by God and is sealed in Jesus' name. Amen. Turn you back to today's pastor. Said it was before the foundations of the world. It was already in order. Glory to God. It was already happening. Glory to God. And we wonder why you think you make a right or make a left. You made a right. But you found out that it was all in the purpose of the hand of God. Glory to God. So it's all by design, God's design. Glory to God. Praise divine. Glory to God. Y'all, glory to God.
pouring oil on it. You know, and the Lord, I'm serious. And the Lord allowed me to know it wasn't by mistake. He let me know it wasn't by mistake. Glory to God. Because the apostle could have did it himself. But the Lord allowed me to see why. And then it just confirmed what he was just saying right there. My God, my God. Oh, Lord, God is awesome. He's an awesome God. So we thank God for his story. We continue on, Lord. Thanks to God. We thank you, God, again. If nothing else, we will stand and be dismissed. But we thank God for the entire service. We thank God for all of it. With two elect ladies, the elect Lady Ford and the elect Lady Perkins. God, my God, thank you, Lord, for what he is doing. And he is ordering their steps. Glory to God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you. Service of the Lord. We thank you, Lord, for both of you, ladies, O Lord, with you. Continue to do it in life, Lord. Continue to order their steps, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Continue to help us all to be what you're calling us to be, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, and we appreciate you, Lord. We ask, O Lord, Jesus, as we leave.